Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. So today we'll be taking up a very important current affair, that is plea bargaining. So today we will see what is plea bargaining, what is the background of this particular topic. Then we will also see how this is relevant in the current context, so how it is important. So we will be discussing it in detail in this lecture. Let's see. But before that, this is our channel, and if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon for getting the notifications. And do share this video with your friends if you feel that you have been benefited from this. Also, we are providing online coaching for GATE, NTA, UGC NET and PGT Computer Science. You can visit our website www.digimento.com or you can call to any of these numbers for more information about our online courses. So let's start. So today we will be discussing about what is called plea bargaining. So let's see what is this plea bargaining. Now let's take these two terms differently, that is these two terms separately, and let's try to understand what is the meaning. So first word is plea, second one is bargaining. So plea refers to basically the literal meaning of the word plea is to make some request. So it is called a request, plea or request we say. Now from this context, what today we will be discussing, plea means a statement or a formal statement made by a prisoner or any person who is convicted of a offense. So plea here means a prisoner or anyone who is convicted of an offense is making a formal statement. And bargaining, you know what is bargaining? It is kind of negotiation. So suppose for example, bargaining, a very good example can be that if you go to any street vendors, if you purchase something from the street vendors, you have the habit of bargaining, no? So that is bargaining, okay? Or negotiating. So plea bargaining, it refers to when a person who is charged with the criminal offense negotiating with the prosecution for a lesser punishment. Now we have seen the meaning of these two words. So the literal meaning you can connect it with the plea bargaining. So plea means making a formal statement or giving a request. So bargaining, so which means that here in this context, plea bargaining means that a person who is charged with a criminal offense. So a person who has been convicted for a criminal offense is negotiating with the prosecution. So negotiation or bargaining is done with the prosecution for getting a lesser punishment than what is provided by law in pleading guilty to a lesser serious offense. So it is nothing but when a prisoner or when a person who has been convicted for any particular offense. So the court of law, if has convicted a person for a particular offense, this particular person is pleading or is requesting the prosecution for reducing the term and the severity of the punishment. That is requesting or negotiating with the prosecution for a lesser punishment than what is provided by law, than what is normally provided by the law. Okay, now plea bargaining, the concept of plea bargaining was introduced in India in the year 2006, and this was as a part of the amendments to the CRPC. So CRPC is Criminal Procedure Code. So this is the criminal law existing in our country. So this plea bargaining was introduced in India in the year 2006 as a part of the amendments made to the CRPC, the Criminal Procedure Code, in Chapter 21A, which contains sections 265A to 265L. So these sections are not important for you, but just understand that in these sections, the provision for plea bargaining was introduced. And here what is important, it is important to see that this was introduced recently in the sense that not many years back, 14 years back in 2016, in the form of amendments. Otherwise, you know, the CRPC or whatever law we have today, it has a colonial legacy. So this plea bargaining provision was introduced in our CRPC as a part of the amendments made to the CRPC in 2006. Now let's come to the details. Only someone who has been charge-sheeted for an offence that does not attract the death sentence, life sentence or a prison term above 7 years can make use of the scheme under the chapter 21A. So this is important. So not everyone, so it is not universally applicable to every convicted person or to every prisoner. So only for certain prisoners or certain category of prisoners or convicts, these provisions of plea bargaining is available. So someone who has been charge-sheeted for an offense, that is charge sheet has been provided that does not attract death sentence. Suppose the charge sheet attracts death sentence, then plea bargaining cannot be done, or even life sentence or prison term above 7 years. So here literally this means that any convict or any prisoner who has a term of less than 7 years can apply for plea bargaining or is eligible for negotiations under the plea bargaining. Also, those offenses that affects the socio-economic conditions of the society, or those offenses which are committed against women or child below 14 years cannot be disposed of using plea bargaining process. So these are also some other exceptions to this, that if any person is convicted or if any person has committed an offense which affects the socio-economic condition of the country, or if any person has committed any offense against a woman or a child below 14 years, then also plea bargaining or the provision of plea bargaining will not be available for this particular person. So these are the eligibility for applying for or negotiating under the plea bargaining. I hope this is clear. So here what is to be understood, the most important point is that plea bargaining is not universally applicable for everyone. So this is what you need to understand. Okay. Now let's come to the rationale. Why was the plea bargaining or such a provision was introduced in our CRPC in the year 2006. So what is the rationale behind it, or what is the objective behind it? Now it was the Justice Malimath Committee on Reforms of the Criminal Justice System which endorsed various recommendations of the Low Commission with regard to plea bargaining. So the plea bargaining was one of the Low Commission recommendations, and it was Justice Malimath Committee on reforms of the criminal justice system. So this committee is also very important. This committee was appointed by the government to study the reforms that are needed in the criminal justice system. So recommendations were already made by the Low Commission, and the objective of the Justice Malimath Committee was to study these recommendations and to pick up the right recommendations, or pick up the recommendations which were very important and very very much required in our criminal justice system. So accordingly, Justice Malimath Committee studied the report of the Low Commission and made these reforms. Now we need to understand what is the rationale or what is the objective. So this can be understood by studying about the advantages of the plea bargaining. First one, this will ensure speedy trial. Why? Because in case of Indian judicial system, Indian justice delivery system, one of the major problems is the pendency of cases. There are a lot number of cases pending before various courts in India, especially with the lower courts. It can be district courts or any court lower than the high court. So comparatively, not that high courts and supreme courts does not have any pendency, but compared to high court and supreme court, the lower courts have more number of pendency of the cases. So this will ensure speedy trial, because as the term of punishment is lesser, the trial can also be similarly done easily or in a speedy manner. Then secondly, it will end the uncertainty over the outcome of criminal cases. Third, it will save the litigation cost and relieve the parties of anxiety, and this will also have an impact on conviction rates, and this will help the offenders make a fresh start. This is because basically the criminal justice system in India that we follow, it is reformative in nature and character. Now, what is meant by this reformative nature and character? This means that the very purpose of the criminal justice system in India is to reform a person by the means of punishments. What the law wants is to reform the person, to bring a change in the person, to deprive the person of his criminal character. So considering the basic principle that we follow, to make some reformation in the life of a person, person, this plea bargaining will be very much important. Okay. Now, let's come to the procedure of plea bargaining. This is also important. Even though this cannot be asked in examinations, having a general idea about this is very important. Now, let's see what is the procedure to be followed. First thing is that the application for plea bargaining, it has to be moved by the convicted. The person who has been convicted for a particular offense or a person who has been punished for a particular offense has to move the application. So here application has to be moved by the convicted person himself or herself. Now the accused will have to apply to the court for invoking the benefits of bargaining. So here the application has to be given to the prosecutor, that is to the court of law. Applicants should state that it is voluntary preference and that he has understood the nature and extent of punishment provided in law for the offense. So two things has to be confirmed by the applicant. One is that it is a voluntary preference, that the plea bargaining has been taken up voluntarily by the applicant, that is the accused person, and also the person is very well aware about the punishment provided in the law for the offense. The court would then issue notice to the prosecutor and the complainant or victim, if any, for hearing. So after receiving this application from the convicted person or from the accused person, the court will issue a notice to the prosecutor and the complainant, that is the person who has given the complaint, or to the victim for further hearing. The voluntary nature of application must be ascertained by a judge in an in-camera hearing which the other side should not be present. Okay. Now, thereafter the court may permit the prosecutor, the investigating officer and the victim to hold a meeting for a satisfactory disposition of the case. Now, this meeting, the parties to the meeting, one is the prosecutor, that is the public prosecutor, second the investigating officer or the IO, and third is the victim, victim or the complainant. So these parties will hold a meeting, together they will hold a meeting in order to reach at a satisfactory conclusion. The outcome may involve payment of compensation or other expenses to the victim by the accused. So, after this meeting, the conclusion can be made on the basis of some negotiations. It can be like some compensation can be demanded by the victim, etc. Once the mutual satisfaction is reached, the court shall formalize the agreement by way of a report signed by all parties and the presiding officer. So, once the agreement or once the conclusion is made, then what the court of law will do, the court of law will make an arrangement for a report, and this report will be signed by all the parties. All the parties means one is the accused, another one is the victim, another one is the investigating officer, and another one is the prosecutor. So all of them, all the parties to this will sign this particular report. Then the accused may be sentenced to a prison term that is half the minimum period fixed for the offense. So after the agreement is signed, then the accused will be sentenced for a lesser prison term, which can be half of the minimum period. If there is no minimum term prescribed, then the sentence should run up to 1/4 of the maximum sentence. So this is the bargaining, or this is the relaxation given to the accused. The accused may be sentenced to a prison term that is half the minimum period, and if there is no minimum period of sentence, then sentence can be up to 1/4 of the maximum sentence defined in the law. So this is about the procedure and the final conclusion. So I hope this video has benefited you, and now you are able to understand, or you are able to, you know, connect what is the plea bargaining with the current context. Now the current context, why plea bargaining has become more important these days, is because of this COVID-19. Many people who have committed some offenses, some criminal offenses related to visa or like employment in some countries and all, they are asking for, or they are demanding for plea bargaining. So that is why again this has come to the news, coming to the news recently. So this is the current context, and I hope you understood what is plea bargaining now. And please do subscribe to our channel and also share this video with your friends. And for online courses, you can visit our website or call to any of these numbers. Thank you.